winro kit matiti kwere matiti ni waberi kakanyi kidul matiti magin ki I Christ Church ya yomtu tuwalde berenungi tiyo kwa dayi udiko meni na matini dakika mmigo karapawi ya boro iku mchawa bene angwen meodiko la winro ya yomtu tuwala tiyo kakanyi ki Johnson Ochiri kachil ki Ogen Rot Daniel magindi jutie kwa dwa I chawa mchalo kirman mimi ni walo pala mama pira tiyo kutuwal na chel favor FM ya ti karman la winjudio ajol gen magitie kwedwa gumot la winjira chakati kibot ogen rot Daniel habidikere moto la winj already ajol matek tuwalo mera
afo yela dit Eric yiwa yom tutuwal dok me beru kan nir matin yin meti wako kwenye ube choring el radio ni wera win ngo malo bang yubu piwa nir matin amen
ok ati ebene kakany la winj radio ki Johnson Ochiri ya jolo mera ni umot la winjudio ajol tuwalo mera
ya afo yela afo yela afo yela
alright
afo
yela matek la winjudio of course wako beri achil noto ngwen tona chel favor FM kadwore chen ichingwele magin kitie kwedba magi aki Christchurch mimi ni walok palo bang ichawa machalo kinman adwako ubotu ajolo matek tutuwal
Afo etu tuan, inmeti awinya iridi uman, chawo ni wamiru wale kachil kuirika wanyu akilok mwekwa na mabaya.
Let's pray as we listen to the word of God.
Loba amako nyingi yesu amira fui tutual pi kisa niko mwa fui bene pi beri ni na machalo tin ay Kristo Yesu.
Father, we thank you for your love and your goodness and on a day like this. Lord, we thank you for this studio and we thank all our other people who are helping us here. And as we listen to your word, may your mercy be upon us, that your word may come with power. That your mercy will be upon all those who listen to this word. We thank you, Jesus. Glory to your holy name. We welcome you amid us. We welcome you at this time. Come together and join with us and cover us in the power of the heavens. And as we share the word of God, may your glory be seen upon every place in, as they listen. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Father, thank you for this day.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Nir matin amir wa tiak wi lokwa ma nir ma wa berka lokone pi yupe wa.
Today we want to finish up with a sharing that we started.
Wa berka lokone umir wa yupe wa kwa wa nen rot Yesu Kristo wa ribekere kacheli deyo ne ka en dugo.
We were speaking about how we can prepare ourselves so that we may meet the Lord, that we join together with him as he comes.
Tini wa mir wa lok malubu kanicha ke ken.
Today we want to only focus on the church.
We are
going to focus specifically on how the church should prepare for the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because the church was left on, Jesus left the church to be as an ambassador on behalf of Jesus.
Kaitie wilobo kan kaitie teka nicha chi olotwale bergi ker ki ker money medonyo ikaberi medweyo palaba
If you are here and you are under some specific church you have that grace to enter into the rest together with God
Nyuri dong ti dong ki kom la kwat kachiel ki jo duju magiti kanicha ma initie yene mayubu in weki don ipolo
This implies that there is a very important work that the pastor or the reverend or someone who is pastoring a specific church that you are in to prepare you to meet the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amir wa kwa kwa nlok palaba.
I want us to read the word of God.
Pien kai kwa nlok palaba miyo doi chao niang kakwene ka umir inibet iye chakti mu iye gena ngon.
Because as you read the word of God you will understand where you're supposed to be and how and what you're supposed to do.
Amir wa kwa nlok palaba mati buk pa matayo chura pa wia bichel.
I want us to read from the book of Matthew chapter 16.
Pa wia bichel. Apa we are bichel bana.
Matthew 16:16.
Yeah, it were kwano neo, umenwa, kaino, you yot, you are kwano, you yot bana. We are kwa mete ki chara nyima nyi. Yesu.
Praise the Lord.
Umir wan weng wa yupe.
At this time, all of us should prepare.
Kape yupe, chipe bi donyi ke.
If you don't prepare, you will not enter the kingdom of God.
Bien, yube wa ene ye mi wa berge kere me donyi ke palaba.
Because our preparation gives us the grace to enter the kingdom of God. Yuma
pul pego yupe.
Those days, many people were not ready.
Dano aborge ken guloyo.
Only 8 people survived.
Karma anua guloyo. Chiel ki lutiana ne.
When Noah and the family survived the great flood.
Ento juma pun guto iye.
But many people perished.
Pien pego yupe.
Because they were not prepared.
Tini aramite kawa nwa lok paraba ini ini yupe o kyalo in.
Today as we share this word of God, I want you to prepare yourself.
Weka kwan loke ini.
Let me read this word.
Matthew 16, verse 16. Kwane kuman.
It reads,
Simon Peter ogamoni in I Christo malobang ye.
And Simon Peter answered and said, Thou art Christ, the Son of the living God.
Wood palobang makwa. In chi yechu udok yeni. In itieki gum. Simon wood payon.
And Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed art thou, Simon. Bajona.
Petie ginmo matiki kom kiremo maunyuti lok man.
For flesh and blood had not revealed it unto thee.
Dok awechini in peter matel loke para.
And I say
abimio lok luak jumu ye an gichung ikom para man.
And I say I say also unto thee that thou art Peter, and unto this rock I will build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. I will give unto thee the keys to the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let us first stop there.
Bible one.
The Bible says
Peter unyuru loge kom Yesu ni Yesu ina ye I wood palabanda.
Peter spoke about Jesus Christ and he said, "You are the Son of the Living God." You are the Son of the Living God who came to deliver us from our death.
Si Peter Yesu do gamborni in.
And Jesus answered and said, No man, no flesh or blood has revealed unto thee these things. These things have been revealed to you by my Father. And I will build my house or my church into thee. And you will be like a rock. And the gate of hell shall not prevail against thee.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Bible says that Jesus answered Peter in a very unique and different way. And Peter was not even aware that he was such kind of a person. And even the things that he was speaking about, he didn't know that he was like a rock. If you prepare yourself on earth here, and you understand who Jesus Christ is, then you will be able to enter the kingdom of God. But if you don't understand Christ Jesus, then you staying on earth will not have value.
So kanicha wewe mirobeki kero mengeyo yetu.
This means that all the churches should be able to understand who Jesus Christ is.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Peter ungeyo yetu.
Just like Peter knew who Jesus was.
Chi utuju loge komene ira ye wood palabame biro kala.
And he said that you are the Son of the Living God who has come to deliver people.
Chi Bible ne Peter do lako dogo chalo God.
And the Bible says that Peter became like a rock.
Umiyo alego ni.
And I pray that the church should know Jesus Christ. The church should prepare themselves and know who Jesus Christ is. But if I speak up, if I say the church, many people are thinking that I'm speaking about the church only, the building. I'm not speaking about the building of the churches. But I'm speaking about an individual. The church is you as an individual. You as a person, you are the church. When you read from the book of Corinthians in the Bible, that don't you know that you are the house, the temple of God? That God himself dwells inside you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's why if you prepare yourself very well, Christ himself comes and sits inside you. But you need to understand Jesus Christ. If If you don't know who Jesus Christ is, you cannot prepare yourself very well.
You mukane gitie lobo kan kiti beare da.
Who are very, very impressive and good character. They stay very well with everybody, with the neighbors, with everyone. But will never accept Jesus Christ as his personal Lord and Savior. And he says, I do good things, I do goodwill to many people. Because even some believers commit terrible sins. So those kind of people, they are always looking at their good work. But our good work cannot give us the assurance to enter the kingdom of
God.
So when you look at those good things as your own, it becomes something very different in the eyes of God. According to God, that becomes your idol, something that you worship except God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. That's why I pray that help yourself and try to evaluate yourself if truly you're understanding who God is. If you come to the point of understanding Jesus Christ just like how Peter did, then you will accept him in your life. After accepting him in your life, then the word of God will continuously be in your life. The church should be able to contain the word of God. The Bible says that it is in the church where we can see God. If that church does not manifest the presence of God, then that church is useless. That's why I am here as a person, but I am here also as a church. The church is you as an individual. Because I have to walk with the church or the temple. Because the word of God lives in the inside of me. When you go to that building that you call the church, you will find the place is silent. Will not even speak to you in any way. But when you see people gathering around, you will find the word of God is also there. Your heart can be broken also. Because the people are the church. And those same people who might not have the word of God, they can also break your heart. That's why you should believe, accept Jesus Christ. So that Jesus can remove those unhealthy things from your life or the ones which are not godly. It is very significant that when you understand Jesus Christ, everything that is not of God will leave your life.
I want us
to read another scripture which is found in the book of Revelation chapter 2 from verse 1 to 5.
Niyabo inini amira kwan in we inini ang mabeh ni kanicha karno in kiti alorikum inaye.
I want to read this scripture so that you may understand that when they speak about the church, it is referring to you as an individual.
Ni lokma kichwala bot jo epecho.
That the word that has been written to the church of Ephesus.
And to the
angel of the church of Ephesus, write.
Jo kid mani. Man lok pangan matieki la kala luka mat.
This thing said he that holds the seven stars in his right hand. Who walked in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks. I know thy works and thy labor and thy patience.
Ni
And now thou cannot bear them which are evil, and thou hast tried them which they say are apostles and are not, and hast found them.
Angiyo itie ka chiro ka diyo chuni kuni chiro chan pinya e ol giri atie ki lok man ikumi pien dong iweko ma mono yam iber kwere ma chom cha ni wako.
And I born and I patient and for my name's sake has labored and has not fainted. Nevertheless, I have somewhat against thee, because thou hast left thy first love.
Kon ipo kit macharo no iporo kwere ki kabiru mamalo.
Remember therefore, for once thou hast fallen, and repent.
Kadong ingut chi ichak tiyo. Kadong ingut chi ichak tiyo gin ma uno iberu ka tiyo ne. Kare mukwancha.
And repent and do the first works, or else.
Kape ingur, abi biru bori chi abi kwanyo uka machi wako ki kabiru ne.
Or else I will come unto thee quickly and will remove thy candlestick out of its place.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible wani lok bang ki kumu perika lok ki jo epetu.
The Bible says God
used to tell
us in Ephesus.
The
Bible says that God was looking at them. How they were patient.
How
they were respectful and obeying the word of God. But they left their first love. They left their first love for God. And began to do things which are not of God. You know, the moment the church begins to do things which are not right, then the presence of God living inside of that church will be taken. That's why if you are the temple of God, you should have the love of God inside you. You should love every Christian. You should prepare every Christian to have love in them. They should have love amidst them. If they don't have that brotherly love, you as a pastor, you as the leader of the church should prepare them so that they can live in that love of God. Because the love of God will prevent other things which are not of God to happen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The
moment the love of God is amid his people, it will cover a multitude of sins.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's why today, if you are a living church, go back to the first love of God. Because God loved you. And God has entrusted you with a number of people. Don't speak only about financial breakthroughs. Don't only speak about the tithes and the giving in the church. Also rebuke those who are sinning. Those who are living in unrighteousness, rebuke them. Don't think about the tithes and the offering that person is bringing and you get scared to rebuke them. Because if you continue to welcome such kind of behavior, God himself will leave you. The Bible is saying here that make sure that you repent. Because if you don't repent, I will come quickly and remove your candlestick. The candlestick signifies the Spirit of God. The seventh Spirit of God that are different. That are always helping you as a church. You know there are seven different kinds and Spirit of God. And if one of them is removed, you cannot fulfill the will of God. You continue to live as you take the church as something not significant. You take the church as your work.
Eto tich makanicha chalo watia timne kumbini ni petich mamua.
But the work that we are doing, as we are doing right now, is not our own.
Luka ugena, wakira gena.
God has entrusted us with this work.
Luka umi, what duk tich eni.
God has given us this responsibility.
Wala kumitaro ki wilo waka nyatwe
hiki palapa. That we may help people in this earth so that they can reach the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
Because if you don't prepare people well, and you leave people to do whatever pleases them without love of God, then God will come quickly and remove the candlestick. And that candlestick is the Spirit of God that is directing the churches. Because the church is on that they may do exactly what Christ has entrusted them to do. If the Spirit of God is not in your life, you cannot cannot administer a church, or you cannot have a ministry, because everything is done by the Spirit of God. The things of God are only directed by the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So it is important that you and me, we should understand these mysteries. If you look at verse 6, Revelation chapter
2,
Revelation chapter 3, verse
1.
The scripture says, "And to the angel of the church in Sardis, write, these things said he that has the seven spirit of God and the seven stars."
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Bible says they have the seven spirit of God and the seven stars. The candlestick also signifies how people are welcoming the message of the kingdom of God. If you welcome the message of God, then the seven spirit of God will also live in your life how you should move in the glory of God and will help you in your weaknesses. But if you don't repent, then that spirit of God that enables you to know who God is will be removed. The Bible says a man who was called Peter understood Christ very well. And after understanding, he began to speak about Jesus Christ. And many people realized that Jesus is the Son of the living God. And they began to worship him. That's why when you understand very well who God is, you will begin to worship him in spirit and in truth. But the seventh spirit of God will be the one helping you. This same seventh spirit of God is the one that helped the church so that the church may stand firm. If this spirit of God are not helping you as a pastor or as a minister of the word, then the church will also take a different direction. You will begin to take a different route. But today I want to speak to you. Careful as you do the work of God. Because the work of God, you shouldn't boast about it. You shouldn't do the opposite of what God desires from you. Because God wants you to do the things the way He desires it to be done. Amen. One day, I was reading one of the scriptures. The Bible says that the Israelites were having some of their enemies. But these enemies were living under a very well-designed fence. The fence of Jericho was well built. They come and kill the children of Israel and they go back and take refuge. And then God gave an information to the children of Israel to go and the Bible says that they were supposed to move round the wall of Jericho once a day for 7 days. So they moved for 6 days. On the 6 days. And the seventh day they were supposed to move around the wall for seven times. I was wondering, why couldn't they just move once for seven times so that the wall can break? That's why the Bible says that God directs people according to His Spirit. If you follow the instructions of God, then what God will do will be of wonders. But if the Spirit of God is not there, you cannot do it.
So,
Joshua was also obeying the instructions of God. And he was obeying what God gave him. Designed it. The Bible says the wall it was broken. If the church does not obey the instruction that comes from the Spirit of God, no miracle, no signs and wonders can happen. Even that condition, they cannot get out of it. That's why the church should continuously stand firm on the Word of God. They should know God just like how Peter knew Christ Jesus. Peter also didn't know that he understood Christ to that level. But he declared some word that actually touched the heart of Jesus. I want us to read the last scripture. We will read from 2 Corinthians. And from whom you can read Hebrews chapter 4, from 5 to 12. You can also read Matthew.
Matthew chora abichel kumchinge piarangwen via piarangwen via kumchinge piari via beer.
Matthew 6:27.
Kwan kong gerin. Corinthians.
2 Corinthians.
Corinthians Mario.
2 Corinthians.
Chura pa we are here.
Chapter 12.
Chura pa we are here. Kumchinge abongwe again.
Chapter 12, verse
9. Kawa kwana lok paraba eni. Irmiri neni yupe ma be. We are a bit kicker me.
And as we read this word, you should ensure that you prepare yourself, not by your own strength, not by your own understanding. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee. For my strength is made perfect in your weaknesses. We know that you are persevering. Maybe even the church members are the one causing a lot of issues on you, or bringing a lot of issues on you as a pastor. The Bible says that his power is there right where you have weakness. Where you're so weak, God will lift you high. Jesus has come to help the church. It's not going to help anyone outside there or anyhow. But will come to assist the person who has the Spirit of God but moving in some condition or some challenges. Maybe there is a condition that is holding you down. But Jesus said, His power is made manifest in thy weakness.
While
you are so weak, He will lift you up. That's why you should stand firm. If you don't have the word of God in your life, you might think that God even doesn't recognize you anymore because of that condition. But Jesus Christ came for the church. And the church is you. And it's not any, the church is exactly you. The Bible says where you are weak, He will lift you
up.
Even if the church looks so weak, as long as the Spirit of God is still there and people are praying, God can still lift that church up. Last month I was saying the church should organize prayers. The church that seems to be weak, if they continue to fellowship and pray, God will lift them up.
Hallelujah.
That is very significant. There is no church that is stronger on its own. The church should always pray continuously. They should always organize prayers continuously. There are people who are supposed to continuously pray as intercessors so that the church may stand. A church that does not pray, they will continuously become weak. They will continuously be weak and they cannot stand. But listen to this.
Ni chuchot ero gamo ni kijana tie marumi pien tegona tutual kama gor tie iye.
And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That is why you should have the reason to worship God. If you understand God very well, then you will realize that in that weakness of yours, God's power is made manifest. Let me leave these minutes that we have so that we may respond to calls from outside. God bless you.
Okay, better to allow in radio. I take a win you look. Mamunya to Matica Katikibo team, Magin Aki, Christ Church, Atika Kanki Johnson, Ochiri, Kachel Kyogen Root, Daniel Magin Duchuki, Kedwa, Icha Machalo Kiman, where a winky botin, Lawin Radio, IT, Kila Pain, when you take it, Tamio Quach Melegamo, where a winky botin, man, favor FM. Hello? Hello? Okay, we're in Yenoro, but it's where the channel in Radio Kubek, Rala in Chimamegutulo, Jero, Beer, Boro, Adeka Boro, Adeka Dek, Rio Adeka Beer, Unu Jera Beer, a beach, Adek Jera Beach, a Bungwen, a Boro, a beach, a beach, Man Favor FM, Halloween Radio, the Caramico, Carpier Beach, we a jail, Mokarati, Kumchawa, and when Meltico, Lawin Radio, hello. Hello, Favor FM. Yes, Harriet Kianaha.
Yes. Ana tiki la penya. Kita pena kwa melega because tiki lo tena penya ama me yiru kwa tiki. Anda pena no.
Okay.
So, yes, so ku perichane la menchua ara ki come pio lo tena ki le marajo lo tena yera la menchua. E before I go to the video, ke ki le ko pera pera perichane ki el tinja beta no jaka ku tiki ko lo tena. I'm going to go to the house. pe wini walofe ni kikelo lo wabolu tire ka ki kumbel chani ki niti ki luon mir ki pengi ka na perne ti ki ka mir beru ku mien mir ki wa ka maleng era an bae bola ye cho chunya ki dungo wini lo farba ma a ki pewa cha wengu ati ko si a meti kong ki chun kere lega matek
ok wafu ya matek harin
ok ariet genu mir tim ki kuman Pew mire ibet ki kiniga ikom dan matimu in maraj. Lok palabang wajan ni, kitiki gum kaki kara yele yele kumi, matay chora bij.
Amen, juyo tiko gamu gere kumeno bene.
Ya, bae buwane itiki gum kaki kara yele yele kumi, no non la bon tiyan lok mo. Pien ini ye, nying yesu, ere weko ki timu in maraj. Bae wane dan me lobo, peki tuero maro, dan magu ye, yesu kristo. Pien indong ki kubi o igang kal palabang, iti wai polo. In ki ñuelu dojo kunu en wer darme lobo peki tweru mari pien in peti darme lobo
because gen wani manu ka gen win ati win radio fega cha manu ki ti lega ki we ala pape ala men kunu ngo mara miru ni umegi ki lare o dwa lo matwanta we en ti ma aki tun dana do mo dana ye ko fe ki toge en ye niangi gen ka tem ki ti tere yo po so en ye niang ka vi lare ni opo
Okay, what for my check, Harriet?
Amen.
Okay, all right. I mean, Harriet and Kupeket Waki, another Halloween deal, pitch out my territory. Why me, you car, King Arachil Kaken, me Kupeket Richard, my Chalakin man, what don't get a kick, Abichilakan, or kill you, my make way Chawani, Yakikin, Halloween radio. Hello?
Hello,
Feva FM. Atima Beatello Kangani.
My dear Patricia Feba.
Yes, Patricia.
I the quality when you let me out of my staff.
Okay, can you Hello? Come back? Hello.
Hello, Patricia. Okay, network pa Patricia peti mabey to Allah la wunyere dong bene wero awa beri ker melor lanchi mo piku bene pe chaw macher tak tol wati kar mana dugo chin e ching tim magite ko de ka kan ber bene manen ker mo to wero dol ne kwere a ki yu diko menin matina chulu matek
okay foto to alo men wa
thank you
wa wunyu ket ma la men wa chan lo ko kwere amira lok mo man no ka da da bori ka wa le ka chel kwere
I want to speak to Ared from Anaga I want to speak something small and then we pray together with you
ngi kare daro mago ye yetu ere ye ke timu ki marach ento ngarmo ye yetu donki kobo ki gang me logo eni ki way polo mire di chunya ye
so you have to persevere because always as you know Christ you'll always pass through circumstances like this
mire ye ri ada e gorn eno ni te karma iti agor ki ene yetu Christo ber ti ka chel
Lord Jesus
ni ena matini
today
Anamogotama.
I have made up my mind
Majuli
to accept you
Macharuata kila
as my personal Lord and Savior.
Kwanya oki vukmeta.
Take my name away from the book of death.
Chonya tini vukmeta.
And write it in the book of life.
Tina Juli Macharuat kila lana.
Today I welcome you as my Lord and Savior. And I want you to live in my life. Teach my heart. Because you are my God.
Anatika nicha ni.
And I am your church. Help me. For the rest of my life. That I may be together with you. For the rest of my days. I pray with faith. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Let me pray for those who want to be prayed for. Father, we thank you. Thank you for your love. Thank you for our sister who is going through difficult times. Father, you promised in the book of Corinthians chapter 3 that you will encourage us just like you did to Paul and Cyrus.
Kariga beki goyogi kariga beki yelugi adada iri kwe chwingi tekara ini duchu
amen
umini matar tina lego bene kwe chwingi la mienwa dare kwona ki kisa ni ma ay polo kwan woro chen ginduju ma yelu chwinye ginduju ma kelo gore kwone la kibone dare mi kero ma nyen meri beka chiel kwere chok chwinye kare duchu pe mi kwone uberite loch me arem ki para pien para pe meru nino ma achiel borwa ento in la ba chike gira choni ngar ma rio lar bori ini bi kwe chunye alego ni wek kwone be gi ker me rio kare duju ka lar bori alego be pi mego ma ti or yat la cho in la ba ma kwo ma chao dok me laro kwo pa dane nying yesu kusa tiw mega mi ching in tiw mega dusu lina mi ching kristo yesa chika rem ki kome me a teko me chol pin ki tiw ma roj ma lubu kore inir matina jiogo nying yesu wantwe rie ching kum nutuo duju ma giti or yat ma bit ki matiri le ba ma ko kongi da ri umgi ki kisa ni ma ai poro le ba ma fui wa wori wa mi de kom ni ma leng ma chala wa lego wa um ko pa jo duju mati wa ko ki re ba yesu wa gonyo gum paruot me loy kom ngara chira chel wa gonyo ki sa pala ba me loy ko pa ngara chira chel me wor in ye man ma yesu ki so luwa wa ye wa ko chup ka kare mo fa in la ba ko ko wa in Yesu Kristo rodwa.
Amen.
Amen. Laba mi tukum medeki bere ka chiel kwerwa
e God bless you and continue to listen to Favor FM.
Amera mi wang nama chi ma kar duyu wa mara mi ne yamo.
I want to give this number that we always give out for you to make calls for prayer requests and any other inquiries.
Kacha gwa bere rong mi okon we gwa be medegi ki ke me log radio enini.
And if you can support this program, that would be also great.
Gam na machim enini.
You can take this number
0820006. Okay, na machim e jera biro aboro a bichiel a chiel a boro a bi nama chima mera benetie okay nama chima mera ti jera pia pia a bi
his number is 0775
oh petti ma petti twa jero abiro a dere
0773
a dere
43
a bi chien
5 6
abiro boro
7 8
mun nama chima mega iromo none jam
okay.